have something that face something else, don't be hypocrite that your face and your heart be the same to others. Don't show the face and your heart is containing different face from your face. Always keep yourself to be a real mu'min, a real believer. So Allah will accept from you your worshipping, your zikr, your khatm. But if you are one whom your heart is something and your face is something else, never anything will be accepted from you. Even if you walk, you will be washing the whole Quran, the Kaaba, and drinking the water of them. Even if you are going to do worshipping from day of beginning to end, never will be accepted from you. If it is accepted from Shaitan, from Satan, from Iblis, it will be accepted from you. Most of the people, and especially Sufi ways, and our way also, full everyone with two faces, his face is something, smiling, showing good face, and his heart full with enmity, with badness, with hatred, with jealousy, with hasad, with bad eyes. To everyone, no one is happy with the other, no one is loving the other, no one is respecting the other, showing only his face that he respects and loves, and his heart is totally different. You ruin your hearts, you make your hearts to be a ruining, a place where the shaitan settling himself, while Allah Almighty is saying, the heart is my house, I want to settle myself in your heart. But instead to settle Allah Almighty in your heart, you are settling your egos, your shaitan, your devil, and you are saying that you are a mu'min. Why you are a mu'min? Because you are saying, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah Almighty is saying, oh my beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the hypocrite come to you and say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, they witness here that you are Muhammad Rasulullah. I am witnessing that you are Muhammad Rasulullah, but I am witnessing that the hypocrite, they are liars, they are lying. Their heart is not the same as their tongue and their faces, saying this from their tongue, from their face, but their heart is full with enmity to you and to Sahab. And like this now, all the people of this time, especially our people, all their hearts against each other, not happy with each other, jealous from each other, enemy to each other, backbiting each other, and their faces smiling to each other as if nothing. This is hypocrite. Hypocrite, munafiq. Allah doesn't like munafiq. Allah doesn't love munafiq. The munafiq, Allah saying for hypocrite, Allah say, I don't love the hypocrite. Rasulullah never loved the hypocrite. And Allah saying that the hypocrite, I am going to make them in the lowest, deepest valley of Jahannam, of hell, under the feet of the kafir and the mushrik. They will be under them, in the lowest level of Jahannam, of hell. And still the people, no one understanding or trying not to understand, he doesn't want to understand. He is insisting to be a hypocrite, that his face is something and his heart is something, his intention is something and his heart is something else, and he is imagining that no one knows. Imagining that no one knows what's going on of him. Be careful. The Allah Almighty, he has awliya whom they are spies for the hearts. They know anything what's going on your mind, in your heart. And no one who is the hypocrite and who is not the hypocrite. Who is a real mu'min, who is a not real mu'min. He is who is a Muslim, who is not a real Muslim. And so, don't be face of a snake and the heart of a wolf. Don't be the scorpion biting. If you are not finding anyone to bite, you will bite yourself. Be careful. Be careful not to harm people, not to harm each other, even by intention, because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the Muslim, the real Muslim, the one whom everyone is saved from his tongue and from his hand, the one who is never harming anyone by his tongue or by his hand. How about to harming everyone by backbiting them, by enmity to them, by bad eyes on them, by jealous from them, by all means of insulting them from inside yourself, and even if there is opportunity for you to insult them in front of people. Anyone ask you that? I know nothing. And you know everything. You are a liar. You are a bad one. If there was permission from Maulana Sheikh, we will not allow anyone to enter this dhikr and khatam and have this bad behavior and manner and hypocrite. But already Maulana say it is open for everyone, we keep it open for everyone. And the Sufi way is not allowing anyone who is committing one mistake in the week to come and sit in the dhikr and khatam on the eve of Friday. But our way is open for all hypocrite or mu'min or Muslim or even a non-believer or even a godless one. Anyone come, most welcome. Not mean that they don't know who is bad, who is not bad. Who is hypocrite, who is not hypocrite. They know everything. They know everything and realize everything from everyone. Don't think they are ignorant ones. Don't think that you can make fun from Awliya Allah. Don't think you can make fun from Allah Almighty and Rasulullah. Don't think you can do as Shaitan imagining to you that no one can discover you and what you are doing is no one taking any attention and you are doing things which no one can be knowing what you are doing. No, there is malaika on your shoulders, Allah witnessing you, Rasulullah witnessing you, Awliya witnessing you, and Allah Almighty making people to realize everyone what is his heart and what is his face, but they feel shy. And they respect to tell everyone that you are like this or like that, but not mean they don't know, everyone knows. Everyone knows, and the one who doesn't know means that he is a one of these hypocrites. Because he is in the same manner, his face dancing and his heart is dancing else. Then he said for Zikr and Khatam, you think he's going to be accepted from him? Allah is going to accept from him? Never. But he is sitting because already Mawlana allowing everyone to be sitting in Zikr and Khatam, even he had this bad manners. Perhaps Allah Almighty will send Hidayah and guidance to him and change him. But he will be saving himself in day of judgment when Allah will be questioning him. He is going to save himself from the punishment of Allah Almighty even in this life. Anyone think that he is going to be saved from the punishment of Allah Almighty? Filling the earth with waste, filling the earth with your dirty breathing, and then coming to sit for Zikr and Khatam with the malaika, the angels trying their best, telling Allah Almighty, we make our best to glorify you, to praise you, and to purify all our deeds so that nothing to be raised to you except when you are pure and clean and purified. And the one of us doesn't really come and sit as if he did nothing and as if he is the awliya for Allah Almighty and he is the best. And he is the worst, and you see something, you sit behind the Imam directly. As if they are the best one and they are the worst one. And some they run away, they sit behind. Why? Because they know that their heart is totally ruined. is dirty, so not to be noticed by this awliya or that whom Allah Almighty appointed that. Be careful that you can cheat everyone, but you cannot cheat Allah Almighty. You can cheat all people, but you cannot cheat yourself. You know yourself better than anyone else, and Allah knows you better than you know yourself. So be careful if you want to be a hypocrite, if you want to be enemy of Allah Almighty, if you want to be a bad one, try to find another kingdom for another God and go and make whatever you want in it. If there is another God, another kingdom, go and make yourself hypocrite, make disobey Allah Almighty, make enemy to the creation of Allah Almighty, make badness and bad heart to everyone. Allah created them because it's not related to Allah Almighty. Is there any kingdom not related to Allah Almighty? If there is no, but in the kingdom of Allah Almighty, say, away Allah Almighty, Allah is not going to forgive you. Allah is not going to accept you. Allah is going to punish you. Allah is going to make you under the feet of the godless, the non-believer, the mushrik in Jahannam. They will be better than you in the divine presence of Allah Almighty. Because you are Muslim and you say, Ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. And your heart is full with hatred and enmity to Muslims, to Mu'mins, to each other. And this goes to Allah Almighty. Really, you are hating Allah Almighty. Hating the people of Allah Almighty, hating the nation of Rasulullah. You are hating Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You are hating the people of Allah Almighty. And for this nowadays, the Muslims, they don't care. They are harming each other. They are making black magic to each other. They are making all kinds of spelling and whispering and making all kinds of to harm everyone and to make everyone to be suffering. Why? For what for? For a little bit of amount of money they are paid by this one or that one to harm the other. And why to be against each other and you say, oh, that we worship Allah Almighty, our God Allah Almighty One, our Rasul is Muhammadun Rasulullah. Our Shaykh is Mawlana Shaykh Nazim. Our way is this Naqshbandiya Aliya way, for example. And we are meeting for Zikr and Khadr. Why you are enemy to each other? Why you are harming each other? Why you are making everyone other to be suffering from you? Why you are not talking with the other one? Why you are making him enemy to you? Whom you are? Whom you think you are? You are nothing. If Allah Almighty wants to erase you, he will finish you. Don't think you are something important. You are even nothing. Allah is saying, if the non-believer is value to me or worth to me something, I will not give him even one cup of water to drink. The one who is hypocrite, not in value to me like a wing of a fly. And for this, to Allah Almighty, everyone who will not keep good respect, good adab, good face, as his heart to be good face, the same his heart and his face, never changing, what inside the same as outside, Allah Almighty doesn't accept him. Allah Almighty doesn't want him. Allah Almighty is not the one whom he is happy with numbers. Even all creation worship Allah Almighty. Allah is going to increase. Allah is going to get any benefit from all of us. And if all the people, they are kafir, non-believer, Allah is going to be decreasing or anything is going to be unbenefiting Allah Almighty, or he's going to lose anything, Allah Almighty. Allah is Allah Almighty. But you are harming yourself. You are a one. You are harming yourself and your Akhirah. And the punishment over your head coming between 1 second to another second. And you are sitting in Zikr and Khatim as if you are very good, nothing, and as if you are a big awliya. And also closing your eyes and making Zikr as if you are concentrating. And your heart is like a toilet, a sewage full with waste. How you are able to mention the name of Allah Almighty in your heart or in your tongue, and you are filling yourself with the waste of people, making yourself a toilet for people, backbiting them, enemy to them, jealous from them, insulting them, controlling them, following them step by step, checking them, and at the end, you wish for everyone all badness, and you wish for yourself the best, and then you say, you are a sincere servant to Allah Almighty, and you want to make zikr of khatam or salat wa salam on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for this Allah Almighty saying, وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا ذُو حَظٍّ عَظِيمٍ. Never will be given this opportunity of goodness from Allah Almighty except to the one whom Allah Almighty choosing him to be lucky one in the divine presence of Allah Almighty, who cleared his heart, cleared his mind, cleared his face, cleared his intention, never harming anyone, neither by his mind, by his heart, by his tongue, by his hand, neither insulting or checking or following anyone or questioning anyone or judging anyone or making black magic to anyone or making enmity to anyone or jealous from anyone. Be careful. Now there is whom advising you. Going to come a time no one to advise the other. And all will be falling in a valley of shaitan, that they will be with shaitan going to Jahannam, never will be saved by Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Only Jahannam will be swallowing them, because they were stubborn, thinking that they are a good one, but really they are a bad one. And every one of you know himself well than me or anyone else. But never know yourself best than Allah Almighty. Allah who created you, he knows you better. And Allah knows what's going on in you. What is your intention? What is in your heart? What is in your mind? What is in your inner? And also what is in your outer? Allah knows everything. What is in your conscience? What you are thinking? Even what you are planning to do? Allah Almighty knows everything. And Allah Almighty, don't think that he is an ignorant one, doesn't know what you are intending to do and doing. But Allah knows everything. But Allah giving you opportunity to repent, to ask tawbah from Allah Almighty, so that he will forgive you. But there is a border. If you didn't repent and you didn't be a good one, and to ask tawbah from Allah Almighty for a limited life, then the punishment will be descending. Don't think that we can tolerate the punishment of Allah Almighty. Don't challenge Allah Almighty. Don't challenge Allah Almighty. Don't think that you can tolerate the punishment of Allah Almighty. If Allah Almighty sent over you a small virus, you cannot tolerate If a headache come over, you cannot hold Saladin. And this is more punishment. Now about Allah Almighty to punish you is a big punishment. What will happen to you? Think well that no one can be run away from the hand of Allah Almighty. Even Shaitan cannot be run away from the hand of Allah Almighty. Allah always catching him. And whenever Allah Almighty wants, he will punish him and finish him also. And the same for every one of us. Don't harm each other. Don't harm people. Don't harm anyone in humanity to you. Even don't harm any creation of Allah Almighty. Always be one whom seeing Allah Almighty with everyone, seeing Allah Almighty in everyone, seeing Rasulullah in everyone, seeing Allah Almighty with everyone. And if you want to make hypocrite, know that you are making it on Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Don't think that you are cheating this one or that one, but directly Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If there is permission, I can name for you one by one whom are sitting in this meeting. Who is a real woman, who is a hypocrite? Who is a real believer, who is an unbeliever? Who is a Muslim, who is not a Muslim? But no permission for this. I shut up my voice. Only I am advising. Be careful. This is what I will tell you. Be careful that Allah Almighty loves the one who always asks tawbah from Allah Almighty, who confessed that he is a bad one. You say, oh, we are bad one. We confess we are bad one. And I'm asking tawbah from Allah Almighty to forgive me and to mercy me. Don't feel shy to ask Allah Almighty to forgive you. Confess to Allah Almighty you are a bad one. Don't say to Allah Almighty you are a good one. No, you are not a good one. Never a one of us is a good one. If you are a good one, you will be an awliya. If you say to something be, it will be. Try, say to something be, let us see, it will be. Then no, nothing. Not even a fly. Be careful. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-'aliyyi al-'azhim. Allah Almighty forgive us and mercy us. And clean our intention, our mind, our heart. And bless us, Ya Rabbana Ya Allah. By forgiveness, by mercies, by hidayah, by guidance. And by purity, clean ourselves, Ya Rabbana Ya Allah. Purify ourselves. Give us, Ya Rabbana Ya Allah, pure self. And change ourselves from a bad ego to a pure godly self, to be divinely self, to be a one whom you are pleased from them, and to one whom their heart, their faith, their tongue, their mind, their intention the same, and no one is harming the other, no one is jealous from the other, no one seeing him proud on the other. Don't be full with proudness. Come down, go down, go down, 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 more, 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 until you will be under zero in humbleness. Be totally even under the feet of Shaitan in humbleness. Even Shaitan doesn't have proudness as nowadays people in this time. These people of this time, they are masters, teachers of Shaitan. And then everyone, he will say, I am the best. While everyone nowadays is the worst. May Allah forgive us and mercy us. This is enough. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim.